The thing I'm most excited about tonight,
what do you got?
Is this movie trivia game.
Alyssa Milano.
That is correct.
Wow! Before
spearing blood.
All over. Matthew Broderick.
Very close. That's the famous Stallone mug.
I want to know if you do yourself the honor of maybe like kind of marrying me.
That blue fairy thing screw.
Yeah. Watch Pinocchio, it's the blue fairy guy.
Whoa!
Wow.
We just went explicit.
Wow.
Harlop is upset.
Don't even look me in the eye. He's upset about that blue fairy.
He is red in the face.
Christian Harlop.
That blue fairy sucks my balls!
I got the right answer.
How many points?
I did not bet enough points.
What? JT is
I win?
Winner!
I'm a firm believer in trial and error. And I believe my client is on trial, it's in error.
Mark Riley is your winner, advancing to the next round.
This is a destruction.
Mark Jute has no points left, and Mark Riley is the winner.
All right, Riley, you won the entire Ultimate Schmoedown. You get the bell. Peace out, Mother F's.
April 13th, the odd couple, Jeff Snyder and Mark Andreyko, heading to Chicago.
Even though they're odd, they are capable of working together. You're a force to be reckoned with, and you can take it all the way.
Going up against Ben Bateman and Riley, who's the boss for a shot to play for the team championship.
2019, we're getting a belt. That's the one goal I want.
I can't wait to beat Bateman again.
There's no way I'm going to get nervous on that stage. I was born to compete. I was born to perform.
Can anyone beat you?
And Mr. Alex Damon, Star Wars Explained himself, puts his title on the line, and it goes down during Star Wars Celebration.
This is just what I do all day, every day. It's hard to stump me. Riley's a legend, okay? He's on Mount Rushmore, and I'm lucky enough to play with somebody with class, a true champion who's taught me a lot about this game.
And I'm going to give him a show in Chicago. You can bet on that. Buy your tickets right now.
Get your tickets now to SchmoedownLive.com.
Just make sure you're there in person. You do not want to miss it.
Stacy, hey, why did you leave? Especially for white bread. I mean, we were always making fun of that guy backstage. We were a family. You were like my big sister in this league. We were always cheering each other on. Like, what went wrong?
Oh my God, this is like an ex blowing up my phone. Listen, I know what's really going on here, and you're scared.
No, that's not it. I just want you to come back to our family, please.
You're scared.
Listen, that's not it. I think you seem to be forgetting who was out first in that triple threat match. So if this is how it has to be, if this is what you want, Korruption.
Whoa. Listen. Whoa. You said you could handle all this? You could be easy with this?
She's too far gone.
What are you doing? You are at this point, like you are gone.
I think we're just wasting our time, Jay.
Jay.
Yeah, I know.
Hey, what's going on here, B team? I can't get rid of you people. What the heck? We have things to do. We're busy. Look, you had your chance with Stacy. You blew it. You gotta move on. Although I do love this mopey look on you guys. It's real cute. We have things to do.
Is the Partridge family having a reunion? Why is she here?
No.
Listen, this is, you know what? All seriousness, at this point, beat her ass.
Let's do it.
Please. Can somebody check the regulation?
joined by the Inner Geekdom Commissioner, the team's commissioner, and she runs the patron. It is the Golden Mike. Emma Fife is here, everybody.
Thank you very much, Christian. It is, it's great to be here for this match, which is, I mean, there's no other way of putting it other than it is a grudge match.
Oh, it is certainly a grudge match. It is former teammates, former family. They were super friends here, Jeannine and Stacy, for a very long time, part of the Viper squad. It was Stacy who was almost like the big sister to Jeannine. And yes, like you said, it is a grudge match because after New York, Jeannine the Machine, by the way, the crowd was with her and really excited for her to be there. And they had this whole attitude change, her and Jay Washington, right? They come back thinking, coming back to a Stacy Howard that was going to be welcoming, and they got anything but that.
Yeah, it's very surprising. I mean, because Jeannine played so great in New York, so I would have thought for sure that they would have returned and Stacy would have been welcoming them with open arms, excited to maybe team up with Jeannine again and go at it, but not the case.
No, it's not the case. What seems to have happened is that there was somebody talking to Stacy. Some would say maybe inside of her head for a long time, and it turned out to be someone you're very familiar with, and that's Grace Hancock.
I certainly have a history with Grace.
Grace Hancock has said that she has seen the greatness in Stacy, that Jeannine and Jay had been ignoring that, and now Stacy had joined Korruption. Now, a lot of people, I have to ask you before we start here, is that they've been wild accusations already about Grace, saying things that she had done for Roxy, things that she was trying to do with Eric Zipper, and just she's moving, manipulating. Can you confirm or deny any of this?
Here's the thing is, I've heard a lot of people taking issue with some of Grace's behavior, and I'm not saying that I don't believe it. I personally haven't witnessed anything for myself that is breaking any rules.
Right.
From my perspective.
But you're not saying she didn't. You just
I'm
don't.
I'm not saying she didn't. I'm just saying that I haven't seen her do it.
Right.
And as far as I can see, she is just managing her team. She is looking out for the best interests of her faction, and that's something that, as somebody who formerly was a manager of a faction, I have to respect.
Well, you bring that up, and what I thought of as this is going on, can you imagine if this was Rachel Cushing versus Clark Wolf right now and how your heart would be breaking?
Oh, it would be so broken.
Imagine how Jay Washington feels right now.
Yeah.
As he sees Jeannine the Machine and Stacy Howard ready to do battle. It's going to be, there was a lot of words said, and we're going to show you right now.
Stacy, listen, I am so glad to see you. Okay, we already got Ethan and Jeannine together.
Yeah, Jay's working on finding you right there. You know what, Jay, I know your game. Congratulations to your success in New York, to the both of you. Where was I in that picture? I'm the most underrated player in this game, okay?
I know.
I've been putting my work in for years, and what have you given me? What belts do I have? You know what, I don't need you guys anymore. I have a new family. I found a place.
At a point I really didn't want us to be at. Now it's you versus Stacy, and this isn't upsetting, it hurts. Stacy was my friend. Her and Brianne brought me into this. Brianne leaves, she's gone from the league. She goes with Mike first, and then Stacy follows suit, but not in the same manner. I'm hurt. You're furious. This is just weird.
Let me tell you a little something about me. Just because this isn't a face that you've always seen, doesn't mean that I haven't been behind the scenes handling things here. I've been scouting this girl for a very long time, and those bozos are sweating and freaking out for very good reason, because Stacy is a champion.
You see, I don't know what they put in your skull. I get you got the redhead connection going with Grace, but I don't believe that's her real hair color. And Ken, he's just there because it looks good for an older man to have two beautiful younger women with him.
What we offered Stacy when we said, come on over to Korruption, and Grace was calling me, she was saying, this is someone we have to pull in. What we offered is a difference and the edge. All you have to do is go out there, Stacy, and take what is yours.
Jeannine, you got a job to do, baby. It's up to you. This is in your ball. This is the ball in your court now. You got to beat her ass, basically, because this got to shut her down.
You know, Jeannine, you said that we were friends, that we're family. You know what? Friends and family, they don't leave their family members behind, okay? They look after their own. They take care of each other.
Yeah, I tried talking to her. I tried appealing to her sympathies as a redhead, but none of it worked. She's too far gone.
So here's what's going to go down today. Okay, Jeannine, you're going to come out and you're going to try your hardest, okay? And your hardest isn't going to be enough. It's my day.
Look, Stacy, I tried. I really did. But it's all business now. It's us versus corruption. I need a win, and if it has to be you, that's just how it has to be. So, let's do this.
Well, Stacy, corruption, all the rest of y'all, it's pretty much only two things you could do about it. That's nothing, and deal with it. Damn it, this hurts.
Shots are fired. If you see the clips leading up to this, how we got here, it was heartbreaking to see when they were all together. They had that triple threat match that they both competed in the first time they ever competed against each other. Jeannine had the better of the round. Mark Andreyko actually wound up winning that whole thing, but Jeannine knocked out Stacy. So there is some revenge here to be had, and it's heating up, Emma.
Yeah, it definitely is. And I mean, you're talking about two players who've always come in with a very strong personality and point of view, and it'll be interesting to see them come to blows today, especially now that they are, again, not working together to elevate one another, but trying to tear each other down.
All right, well, here we go. Here's some notable accomplishments for our competitors. Jeannine the Machine, she was a Rookie of the Year nominee. She was part of the first New York Live event, and she also has been in the big triple threat match during Collider Collision. Stacy Howard, also part of that big Collider Collision match. She was a quarterfinalist and beat Baby Carrots, the former winner, and she is also known for her extraordinary entrances. They both are. They are both known for extraordinary entrances. Mm-hmm. So with that being said, Emma, you ready to get going?
Well, I think I think we're ready to rock and roll.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's time for the Movie Trivia Schmoedown. Introducing first, led to the ring by her manager, the urban gladiator, Jay Washington. She is the 2018 Rookie of the Year nominee with a record of 2-3, one knockout, Jeannine the Machine!
What's going on here? I heard lots of yelling and screaming, but no Jeannine.
Oh man, look at that. Oh, they're clueless.
Oh, the way they were.
Oh, Jay Washington. Wow, they're ready.
The gauntlet has been thrown down in the form of a photograph commemorating the love that used to exist between these two competitors.
To be fair, they tried. They tried to get her back, and they said Stacy just wasn't having it.
Yeah.
And her opponent, representing Korruption. She is the number 11 ranked contender with a record of 4 wins, 3 defeats, and 1 knockout. Led to the ring by Grace Hancock and the Pit Boss Ken Napzok. She is Sassy. She is Stacy Howard. Grace and Emma, that look on the bed, Ken, and Ken with the big
classic move. Ken.
Yeah, see, Grace is something else.
Yeah, there's some kinship between redheads. You know, that's what I'm sensing with Stacy and Grace anyway.
So far, Korruption having an okay year here. Obviously, they lost their bid with the Inner Geekdom Championship, but they won their match.
Yeah.
Obviously, the teams match, but now the singles match, the grudge match is about to get underway, and round number one is going to work like this. The competitors will have 8 questions. 8 questions worth 1 point apiece, 15 seconds to answer the question. Don't forget about your 3 JTE rules as well as your challenges. And with that, we ask Stacy Howard, are you ready?
Ready.
The Machine, are you ready?
Let's do this.
Then let's get ready to Schmoedown! All right. Okay, here we go. All right, first one is from Action Adventure. Action Adventure. Which film in the Indiana Jones franchise involves a secret location called the Well of Souls?
I like those Indiana Jones movies.
It's, I love
most of them are pretty good. Can we like to forget the Kingdom of the Crystal Skull existed? You
what
just kind of sweep that one. Exactly.
Never heard of it.
Precisely.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and Stacy?
Temple of Doom.
That's incorrect. Jeannine?
Kingdom of the Crystal Skull.
Looking for Raiders of the Lost Ark.
Swing and a miss from both competitors.
Yeah,
all
one.
Right.
Question,
this is a very hard question number 2 in the category of family films. In The Goonies, what is the name of the Fratelli brother that Chuck befriends?
Now this is one of my favorites.
That is you know, if you want to just encapsulate what it meant to be a kid in the 80s, I feel like Goonies is maybe
5.
You'll be disappointed in your own childhood.
True. 4. 3.
Oh, repeat the question.
All right, first one.
In The Goonies, what is the name of the Fratelli brother that Chunk befriends?
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, pens down, and Stacy.
Oh, I think I misheard it. I said Chunk.
That's incorrect.
Incorrect.
Okay.
Sloth.
Sloth is correct.
Yeah. Okay.
Sloth is correct. Okay. All right, so here's your next one. Next one is dramas. Who played Sonny Wortzik in the 1975 drama Dog Day Afternoon? Big fan of the Dog Day Afternoon. You ever seen it?
No, I actually haven't seen Dog Day Afternoon. I have seen dogs on a day in the afternoon, though.
4. That's good. 3, 2, 1. Jeannine.
Al Pacino.
Yes, it is.
Correct.
Stacy.
Al Pacino.
Okay.
All right.
2-1. Next question.
Question number 4 in the category of animated. In Disney's Dumbo, what is the name of Dumbo's mouse friend?
Let me tell you, it's in the live action, the mouse friend doesn't do jack crap.
Really? Yeah. That's disappointing, because, yeah. I mean, Disney is known for their friendly mice, yeah. So it's really
5,
just taken away.
Maybe Burton isn't. 4, 3, 2, 1, and Jeannine.
Didn't have it.
Didn't have it, Stacy.
I said Gus.
That is from Cinderella. We were looking for Timothy. Timothy Q. Mouse.
I like how Emma was like, I know that one. I'm going to tell you what Gus's name is.
Shut up.
I know my Cinderella.
She was going to add dummies, but we cut it out. All right, here we go. Start with fantasy sci-fi. What was the name of the second film in the Matrix trilogy?
That was the first movie that I saw legally that was rated R when I turned 17.
Walked out of.
That I walked out of.
5.
Maybe I should have done that.
4, 3, 2, 1. Pens down, Stacy.
The Matrix Reloaded.
It is.
Correct.
Jeanine.
The Matrix Reloaded.
Okay,
right.
Jeanine keeps that lead up by 1. Next
All right.
One.
Question number 6 in the category of comedies. Name one of the 2 actors that played the sarcastic a cappella competition announcers in the Pitch Perfect trilogy.
The actors?
Yeah, yes. either one of them. Pitch Perfect. Yeah. Actually, that was quite similar to my college experience.
Was it too?
Yeah, we had a cappella was big.
I know you and
James
I don't
Madison
doubt
University.
It. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and Jeannine.
Elizabeth Banks.
Correct.
Stacy.
Elizabeth Banks.
Correct.
Okay.
Also accepted, John Michael Higgins.
Next one, 90s movies. What 90s teen drama starred Tyrin Turner, Jada Pinkett, Lorenz Tate, and Samuel L. Jackson? The 90s
Lots.
Movie. Enjoyed this movie very much.
Mm.
Not a spoiler. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Stacy?
Do the Right Thing.
It's incorrect.
Incorrect.
And Jeannine? Didn't have it. Looking for menace to society. Menace to society, okay?
Yes. Menace right.
Well, then you get up here.
Society.
Stacy.
Roman numeral
two. Now your match, be quiet.
All right. Stacy yelling at her former manager. Yelling at Jay Washington, telling her to keep it shut.
You need a cooler.
Final question in round number one. Question number eight. In the category is horror slash thriller. Who directed Gone Girl? Gone Girl filmed some pickup shots on the Universal lot in the Metro sets.
While you were singing your Pitch Perfect song.
Well, I was singing my Pitch Perfect song in Courthouse Square. Yeah.
4, 3, 2, 1. Pens down, please. And Jeanine.
Ben Affleck?
No.
No.
David Fincher.
That's
that is correct.
Stacy ties the game
David
up.
David Fincher.
So now round number two begins. We are tied at 4. And round number two, the competitors are going to spin the wheel. They will spin the wheel.
Look at that even score up there.
Wow. Barely
mm-hmm.
All right. The competitors will spin the wheel. If it lands on a category they do not like, they can spin again, unless, of course, it lands on opponent's choice. But there will be four questions. Four questions worth 2 points apiece. Unless they go to multiple choice, then it goes down to 1 point. There are steals available in this round. Jeannine has 2 JTEs left, and Stacy has 3. Both have their challenges. Tie game here. Stacy
Howard. Game.
Stacy Howard is the higher ranked, so she can choose. Would you like to go first or second?
I'll go second.
I'm going to go second. Right. Jeannine, please spin from the wheel, not the pegs, and here we go.
And while we're on the category of the wheel itself and the categories you might spin therein, we do have 2 sponsored Patreon slices on the wheel today. They are Jim Henson and Crime Movies. We will say the names of those patrons should those slices be spun and kept by our competitors.
All right, good. Here we go. Here's the spin. Jeannine gives her the spin. What are we landing on here? You know, she might be looking for comedy.
I don't know what she has
Julia
a lot
Roberts.
Of strength. She's got a lot of strength. She's actually a very well-rounded player.
Would modern classics.
Modern classics.
What's she going to do? Spinning away from modern classics. So what is she aiming for here, Emma? What do you think?
I don't know.
I think she might be going for either Julia Roberts or maybe Jim Henson.
We will see what happens.
What is going to hit? But it goes, it's going past. Oh, look at this. Oh, this might be big. That's big. That's big for her.
Romantic
that's
comedy. That is a strong category.
She'd like that. All right, I will ask the questions here in the category of rom-coms. Here we go. 4 questions. Jeannine, here you go. In Legally Blonde, the resume that Elle gives to Callahan is printed on pink paper. What else is it that, according to
Elle, it's scented.
That's correct.
That's correct.
Thank you. All right. Who plays Amy Schumer's sister in the film Trainwreck?
Brie Larson.
That's correct.
That's correct.
Okay. In Bridget Jones's Diary, Bridget is invited to what she thinks is a costume party. What does she dress up as?
A Playboy bunny.
Correct.
That's correct.
Jeannine wiping it up right now. And your last question here. Last question here. Nick Cannon's Love Don't Cost a Thing is a remake of what 80s rom-com?
Can't Buy Me Love.
Correct.
Man,
Jeannine cleans the board with romantic comedies. And now Stacy needs a category that she is going to be strong in, or she can be in serious trouble here. Here is the spin by Stacy as she makes her way. But what a
that
was
focus.
Jeannine smirked when she got it, and you saw why. And then Stacy.
Oh yeah.
It's funny. Jeannine took the approach of the light spin. Stacy did the hard spin.
I mean, there's no doubt in anybody's mind that Jeannine is extremely good at romantic comedies, and whew, man, did she ever prove it. So Stacy is definitely going to need a strong category here.
Jay Washington was screaming for opponent's choice.
We'll see what happens.
Oh, wait a minute.
Wait a minute.
Comedy.
Comedy.
Shh. Gotta give you a count. You gonna stick
comedy.
With it?
All right,
comments. All right, we're gonna start with comedies here. Emma, are you ready to get
going? I am ready to do this. All right. Stacy, first question, category of comedies. What classic comedy features the characters Danny Noonan, Ty Webb, and Carl Spackler?
Clueless.
That is incorrect. Jeannine for the steal?
No. I don't know.
All right, looking for Caddyshack.
Okay.
Caddyshack. All right, next question. Who plays Larry Valentine in I Now Pronounce You, Chuck and Larry?
Oh,
Five?
It's Adam Sandler.
It is not Adam Sandler. Jeannine?
It's a stupid name. It's stupid.
Five. Four. Three. Two.
Kevin.
One.
Ugh. All right. Really close, Jeannine. We were looking for Kevin James. Kevin James. Couldn't quite get it there, but that's all right. All right, moving on. Okay, next question. What did the Wet Bandits change their name to in Home Alone 2?
Multiple choice.
Is it A, the Sticky Bandits, B, the Tacky Bandits, C, the Dirty Bandits, or D, the Slippery Bandits?
Five.
The Slippery Bandits?
Incorrect.
The Sticky Bandits.
That is correct.
1 point. All right.
1 point steal. All right.
Last question.
Final question, category of comedy. Who plays Ellie Wagner, who, along with her husband, becomes the foster parent to three children in 2018's Instant Family?
Rose Byrne.
That is correct for two points.
All right.
Hanging in there.
Now, this is a thing, though. It's the third round, and Jeannine sees herself with a 7-point lead going into the third round. Stacy Howard's going to have a really strong third round here in order to keep this game going. But the way it works is that the competitors will choose from 1 to 20. They'll get three numbers. The first one worth 2 points. Second one, 3 points. Third one is 5 points. All right, we're going to start with Jeannine, who has the lead here. Jeannine, please pick three numbers.
3, 6, and 9.
3, 6, and 9 for Jeannine and Stacy.
7, 12, 16.
7, 12, and 16 for Stacy. Stacy will start here with number 7. I got it. Stacy, are you ready to go?
Yes.
All right. Famous actors and actresses. Famous actors and actresses is your two-pointer. This is your two-pointer. Which Ocean Eleven's actor appeared in the film Cool World?
There's a lot of actors in Ocean's 11, so.
5, 4.
Don Cheadle.
Brad Pitt.
Brad Pitt.
All right, so Stacy needs to hit this one. If Stacy does not hit this, Jeannine will win via TKO. Here it is. We are going to number 12 here, Stacy. Family films. All right, here we go. Family films. Okay. Which character does John Ratzenberg voice in the Toy Story franchise? Five, four, three.
It's the Mr. Pig.
Two. And your winner by way of technical knockout, Jeannine the Machine.
I mean, Jeannine came to play today. There is no doubt about that. I mean,
she said it was all business,
and she meant it. She's fun romantic comedies, but other than that, she was stone-faced the entire time, and man.
Well, she was cracked that smirk because she knew she had it.
That's
true. She knew the romantic comedies was a strength, and she hit it, and she finds herself right back in those rankings. She is now 3-3. She has 2 knockouts now. That's an impressive win over Stacy. And Stacy and Korruption, I have a funny feeling, are not going to be thrilled in that post interview because Stacy didn't even shake Jeannine's hand. She just stormed off the field.
Yeah, I mean, the Korruption is they're an interesting force. It'll be. I'm curious to see what happens in terms of their attitude towards Stacy after her loss today.
Well, we will find out because Jen Sturger is back with Jeannine and Stacy. Here we go.
What's up, guys? I'm backstage with Korruption and Stacy Howard. Stacy, that was still a really great match. I know that there was a lot of emotions going through your head out there with Jay Washington trying to psych you guys out. Ken, how are you feeling about your team member here?
Well, Jennifer, let me tell you how we're feeling. We're feeling okay.
We're feeling fine. Did we want to win? Well, of course. That's the point of the game. But we don't freak out after one loss. We don't believe in flash in the pans. That's for the fans to get hyped about one big win, and then it just flitters away. We are not just a flash of gold in a pan. We are the gold mine. And sometimes it takes a while to dig deep and find the gold that is down there. And Stacy, we're going to rebuild. We're going to keep going. We're not done. She knows it. She's still confident. I've never said anything bad about Jeannine. I believe in Jeannine's talent. I don't know if I believe in Jay as much as Jay needs to believe in himself, but I'm happy for both of them. Big win. They can celebrate. They can go get a cupcake and maybe a raspberry phosphate after. So happy for both of them trying so hard today, and it paid off, but that's just one.
Stacy, do you regret sticking with comedies? I mean, that's such a broad category. I feel like if you would have gotten romantic comedies, you probably could have run the board just like Jeannine did.
Oh, absolutely. Every single question she got, I knew. Those were softball questions. Mine were very difficult. I didn't know all of them. I didn't know a lot of them. Hell, those were super hard. Who's ever said Cool World? What the F is that? What is that? Come on. But you know what? It's fine, okay? Because I'm going to get another match. I'll win. And then I'm coming back for Jeannine. This isn't over, not by a long shot.
And I mean, we're still obviously left in the dark right now about who your partner's going to be. I'm sure Grace has something pretty amazing cooked up for you. Still not giving me that exclusive? We gave you a mic for a reason.
I'm still not giving you the exclusive, Jen.
Great. And I'm back with Jeannine the Machine. I mean, I think today you proved that you can live up to your moniker, rom-coms. I mean, is there anything you don't know about that category?
Very few little things. I was very happy to get rom-coms. It's my thing, and I've been pretty lucky with the wheel, so this was no different.
And I'm sure being out there, you know, looking across the table at your old teammate, that had to bring up some emotions for you out there.
Maybe yesterday, but today's a new day. It's all business now, so it is what it is.
Jay, how did you prepare her for this match? Because like I said, there has to be, like, there's just that underlying thing, you know, having it be your former teammate sitting across the table from you and talking a lot of smack, let's be clear.
It's a little difficult in this situation. Normally, I go out there, there's a certain Jay Washington that hits this curtain that goes out and is with whoever, whether it be Jeannine, Ethan, even when it was with Stacy, and it's a certain way. But when it's Stacy, somebody you consider a friend, and you realize you have to put all that to the side. And like Jeannine said, it's now business. No more family to this. It's business, and business was taken care of. We saw what happened in round two. Both of them have the same strength, romantic comedies. Stacy said, hey, I'm going to let her go first because she thought she was going to get steals. Well, you can't steal something in a category somebody knows back and forth. And so that ended up being ultimately her demise.
Absolutely. And let's be clear, you put on a hell of a show in New York against Chance. And so having play another member of Korruption, does this feel like it's validating you and lifting you back up after New York?
Oh, definitely. I was so ready to take on Korruption for a second time and get that win. I definitely needed a W here, and I made it happen. But to make it happen.
You know, again, let's go back to the leather jacket boy. You know, that thick-ass coat that he wears. That was a fluke, his victory. We all know this because of the question. And now she beat another member of Korruption. That's two down. That kind of makes her the Korruption killer. I would say Korruption killer and crusher, but that's KKK and we're black and we can't do that moniker together. We just can't, so it just won't happen. But nonetheless, that makes her able to take her down. And Stacy did want to challenge Jeannine again. And that's fine. We'll take you if you climb back up the ranks.
Again,
you know, you're like the number 12th ranked competitor, or maybe 13th. But you have to work your way back up to this. And I'm sorry it hurts, and it's the truth. But maybe Grace can school you and skill you on some things besides just how to keep red hair red. Or maybe Ken can show you how to hit the ground on one knee and struggle to get back up. Or maybe Chance can show you what Salvation Army to buy a coat from. And Mike can just go cry in a corner when he loses. I mean, things like that happen.
And today, you know, I hope I just showed her that she chose wrong.
Sometimes people make bad decisions, and that bad decision was challenging the machine.
So let's be clear. You are open to a rematch, though.
Oh, definitely. Anytime.
But she got to work her way up.
Yeah.
Well, look, actually, you know, the funny thing is Korruption, very supportive over Stacy. And Stacy was, for the most part, silent. And then really teasing that teammate.
Yeah,
really
absolutely.
Teasing that teammate or who that teammate's going to be, and then they're kind of calling out Jeannine and Ethan down the line of the, of those teams yeah. matching up. Well, we don't know who our teammate is.
We really don't.
You've got to be confident if you're going to call out Jeannine and Ethan.
I mean, Jeannine and Ethan are for sure going to be a huge force to be reckoned with. I cannot wait to see them team up and take people on. I mean, Jeannine, once again in the match today, proves that she is one of the strongest up-and-coming competitors that we have in the league, and she's been in it for a year now.
You're
so
right.
She's really got some experience under her belt, and it has done a world of good for her. But I mean, I gotta hand it to Korruption that they like to keep you guessing.
Well, they keep you guessing, but they stuck with their player.
Yeah.
But the thing is too, Jay Washington obviously wasn't taking a lot of shots at Korruption, which is good. You know, they took the victory. But what I will say is now Jeannine finds herself right back in the dance, because mm-hmm. now she is 3-3, and she is – look, this singles division is wide open right now, and Jeannine is now getting back up on those ranks, puts herself in the, probably in close to the top 10 here, and now we're going to see some big matches. Who is she going to play next? You know, there are names that were thrown out there, but we'll see.
Yeah, we will.
All right, well, guys, thank you very much for this match between Jeannine the Machine and Sassy Stacy Howard. Go ahead and comment, like, go and join the Facebook group, right? Go to triviasd.com, download all these episodes podcast-wise, and make sure that you join the Patreon today. You get to talk to Emma. You get to talk to so many different competitors. There's so many different tiers out there that are right for you. Join the Patreon, patreon.com/schmodown. And don't forget about the live events. We are coming to Chicago. We're going to Houston. We're going all over the place. And all you need to do is go to the schmodownlive.com. Get your tickets. For the commish, Emma Fife, I'm Christian Harloff. We'll see you next time.
Yo, hey, good to see you. Listen, understand, startled, big black dude. We'll get past
it. No, it's just you. You're clearly waiting for me. I just need to get to the chase.
I'm not running. I appreciate everything you're doing as commissioner, right?
Thank
Trying
you.
To clean up after the mess that Thad had. Mm-hmm. But however, Korruption, like, they stronger than ever in all this is happening, and they still running around here. And then you got Grace coming out of nowhere. And here's the problem. I think Grace poisoned Stacy's mind to go ahead and leave. Like, why is she here? I think she's the one who told Roxy to deal with all this stuff with the Odd Couple. Like, why are we doing this? Why are you letting this happen?
Well, because I'm giving Grace a chance. She hasn't done anything thus far to break any rules to justify me kicking her out. So, listen, if anybody understands having an issue with Grace, it's me. She definitely stabbed me in the back in the past. I am willing to believe that she has turned over a new leaf.
She can baptize the song, because that's the only way she'll turn over a new leaf, whatever. That is Grace. She is not Grace Korruption. Korruption, Grace. They go hand in hand, Emma.
They're a faction. I can't tell people to not have a faction. I used to manage a faction, Jay.
You have to remind me of that, but you're doing great as a commissioner. Speaking of which, I got Ethan and Jeannine, and they need a match.
Yeah, they'll have a match.
So with who? So they can prepare.
There's going to be a match against a team, because they'll be competing in the team league of the Schmodown, and I will let you know who that is very soon.
Yeah, which means you know now, so I'd like to know. Emma, can you tell me who, please? Who?